Hey people, it's Wednesday, January the 20th, and it is 1:38 in the afternoon, and I'm here at Old Weston Road and Dupont Street, and I'm going to be walking east along Dupont Street, if I can cross this street here. I'm not sure what's going on with this intersection. Does not seem to want to let me cross. I'm just going to go for it because I don't know what the heck is going on. So it's around -5 Celsius. Feels colder though, there's a wind chill. Feels more like it's pushing the -10 range with the wind, but luckily the wind is not blowing in my face. Passing under the rail corridor. And there's a pedestrian crossing as well. Leads up to the pedestrian crossing. Now Dupont Street is, it's a main street in the city, but it's not a popular street in the sense that Bloor and College are. It has stretches of retail, but it's not like a mostly unbroken stretch the way those streets are. Kind of as a mixture, has retail stretches, residential stretches, and industrial stretches. And they're kind of just hodgepodge along the way. Like here we have a bit of a retail section. And some industrial. And some residential. So it's all kind of mixed up that way. Where I started the video was just at the entrance to the Junction neighborhood. And adjacent to the Junction is this area which is known as the Junction Triangle. The street definitely has a bit more of a gritty look to it than the more popular retail strips along College and Bloor. This is north of Bloor, and south of St. Clair. There's a little Charlie Brown Christmas tree. Definitely has a lot more of a working class vibe around here. This neighborhood, it's a bit of a throwback to how a lot of Toronto's main streets used to be. Before gentrification kind of took over and they became popular with yuppies and hipsters. There's an old plaza with residential above. No doubt this replaced what was a traditional urban storefront section along this block. It's a shame. Wonder if it burnt down or something. Just a guess. That plaza itself looks pretty old too. It looks like it was probably built in the 1950s. Say, this is a part of the city that I rarely ever come to. I did do a video along here a long time ago when my channel was still fairly new and I was using my phone as my camera back in the shaky pre-gimbal days. I think that was the last time I was in this area. And at the time of shooting that video, that was the first time I had been to this area. So as you can see, there are some new residential developments taking place. Gonna see what is up here. Well, seems to be a parking lot. I guess it leads to this crossing right here. So as I said, you'll find lots of industrial buildings along DuPont. Because a rail corridor runs alongside the street for much of its length. So all kinds of industry set up shop alongside the rail corridor. Now lots of those old industrial buildings have been converted to other uses, such as this one right here. Here we got Lansdowne Avenue. This will lead south past Bloor Street all the way down to Queen. And that used to be the site of a notorious coffee time restaurant, which was at one time a fairly popular chain of coffee and donut restaurants, but I don't think there's any left. Or if there are, there's just a few scattered here and there. But this one used to have a awful reputation. Of course, now it's something else, Mr. Cafe. And I've heard these buildings were also a bit of a interesting place to live. Speed is kind of giving way to more residential character. Maybe I'll cross again. So I was thinking from this side, there might be some cool views of the skyline. As we are making our way towards downtown, or the northern edge of downtown. Go. We can see One Bloor East and the Four Seasons, and you can see further down to Aura. And the Financial District and the CN Tower. So there's that rail corridor I was talking about. And here you can see a lot of these industrial buildings lining the street. And I think this was at one time a mall, a shopping mall. The Galleria, I think it's still up here, or at least part of it. It was like one of the older, small malls in the city. It was just sort of plunked down in this old inner city neighborhood. Back when building shopping malls was all the rage, it always seemed kind of out of place. And I believe it's being redeveloped now as a high density new residential community with multiple towers. I only went inside this mall one time just out of curiosity. And it was mostly dead. I think it was a dead mall for quite a long time, other than a few remaining anchors that kind of kept it going. It was also very small. It wasn't like a big mall or anything like that. See, they still have a grocery store going, Rexall and Planet Fitness. Oh, here we have a rendering of the redevelopment. I don't know if you can make that out, but there's at least four high-rise towers. So I think that mall's days are numbered. Here we are at Dufferin Street. hand is starting to feel a bit numb, even though I have two gloves on. This is definitely one of the coldest days we've had in a little while. It's been fairly mild the last couple of weeks. See a crossing for the rail line. Definitely a gritty feeling around here. I kind of like it though. I think every city should have some neighborhoods that are a little bit on the more rough around the edges side. A little bit of grit and grime. That being said, there's no indication that this is in any way a dangerous area or there's a high crime rate. It just looks a little rougher. There's an awesome old factory building. We're here at Dovercourt Rd now.
the 26 DuPont bus.
Wow, you can see on the other side, facing the rail corridor, it's completely covered with graffiti, as you can see right through the building. You can see this has been converted at least partially into gallery and studio space. The Hamilton Gear Building. Train. Awesome old factory. It's looking south down Ossington Avenue. Well, looks like this old building is slated to be redeveloped. a giant parking lot for a Sobeys grocery store. At one time, this was probably in another industrial property. Crossing Shaw Street. Another new residential development. These start to proliferate the further east we go along DuPont. There's a number of sites where new condominiums are underway. Of course, that's getting closer to downtown. Sidewalk closed. Well, that's very unsafe. So basically you're forced to just run across this busy street here. Well, I guess it's okay. But as I've said in some other videos, in Toronto, no sidewalk goes unobstructed. So I think we passed through the bulk of the industrial section of DuPont. So I think I will wrap up this video right here. I might continue on with another video doing another part of DuPont. But in any case, if you enjoyed this, please, by all means, subscribe, like, share, comment, tell your friends and your family, and even your worst enemy. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. I've been posting daily lately. That's a cool alley. And if you'd like to support the channel, there's a link in the description where you can do so via PayPal. So thanks for watching. And be sure to keep checking back because, as always, I will continue.